Hi everyone, Frederick here from Simple System Trading. Today's video is about a setup to automatically sync your lines or zones or share them inside ShareaChart. What you need is scheduled here in a drawing. You can see this one on my blog post as well. You need two studies, one on this side and one on the receiving side. In the last video I discussed the import level study, and I will show that again in the demo. You also need a study that will create CSV file based on the use of drawings. And with some syncing software, you can then push those files to your cloud platform. With that, you have a direct URL to those files, and you can use that with this import level study to show those levels on other people's charts. So that's what we will show you in this video. So first I will start to explain a little bit about the drawing tool to CSV file study. We'll set up a cloud computer quickly and some synchronization software, and then you will see how it all comes together. So let's start with the ShareaChart interface here. I have two charts loaded. There's a ES chart and there's a CL chart. This is the ES chart. And this is the CL chart. In my toolbar, control bar, I added the tools of the horizontal ray and the extending rectangle. And I also added the tool config buttons. It's not needed, but I do it to show you how you can quickly change configurations of the drawings you use. So let's say we use a horizontal ray in that configuration. We can also use another one in a different configuration. And those ones are set in the tool configs, horizontal ray config. You see number two and number one as different styles. That's how you can use those buttons. And I use them to draw zones and lines. And this is the way you can use the study. The study is loaded right here, two versions of them. I loaded one which has the horizontal ray selection. This will detect a horizontal ray when it is drawn or updated, and it will write that to file. And I named this file csvlines-cl because this is on the CL. And it will write this file every 5 seconds when there are updates. So that's what this study does. The second study does the same thing, but for the extending rectangle detection. And it will write them to this zones file, which we're going to later use. So this chart has those two studies loaded, and whatever I'm drawing will be placed in the CSV file. So also, if I'm gonna add some text, for instance, this label will be adjusted in the CSV file. If I'm moving the drawing to another place, that will also be updated in the CSV file. So that way you can move things around, change things if you want, add some text, and it will be added. Can change the color as well on the fly. change the line width and the line style if you want. It's all possible. We have the same study configuration here on the ES, and the only difference is that I named the file differently. These are the lines, and these will be the zones for the ES. And also here I can start to draw some of those lines and zones. If I do that, all those will be added to the CSV file as well. Change a few things here, and then we can move on to the next part of the demo. So right now we have four files, two for the CL, two for the ES. And those files need to be synchronized with a cloud platform. So let's look at that cloud platform. For the cloud platform, you can use many things. I'm showing you quickly how you can do it in Vulture. There's a link to Vulture on my website in the blog post here. And this will allow you to set up a web server pretty quickly. There's other ways to do it, and this is just for demo purposes. I'm not going into security and other things, but that's totally off the scope of this demonstration. What you can do here, you select the server location, you select the server type to be an application with a LAMP application. This basically means you will deploy a server, a Linux server, with Apache, a MySQL database, and PHP. You select the size. There's some additional features. I'm not going into that. You just click deploy, and it will start installing the cloud instance. While we wait, I can tell you a little bit about the syncing software. There's a lot of options there as well. GoodSync is a option to get the paid version. It's $50. It has all you need to automate the job, and that's what you need. You need to automatically detect the changes, and that will upload it to your cloud computer. Another option is FTP sync synchronizer. I will use that in the demo. But there are many, many more applications, and you could probably write something yourself as well. Apart from the Vulture, you can also get some web hosting and do a similar thing. The instance is ready, so you click here on Manage, and you will get a few details here that we will need to set up the synchronizer. First have here an IP address, which is needed to set up the synchronizer. So the synchronizer, this is a trial version. Let's start to upload the files to the FTP server. We fill in that IP address here. We have one account, it's the root account. It's not the most secure way to do this, but there's other options which you can check out on the internet. You're going to use the SSH protocol here. You can test connection. You see it's working. So we can click next. We will have to point to the local directory where the files are stored. And as you could have seen on that share chart study, I have them in the C directory SSD test. That directory will be synced to the web root. The web root in Linux is slash var www, HTML. This is the standard root directory of the web server. So what we're going to do is all the files in the local directory will be synchronized into the HTML root directory of the server. I'm just going to go with some pretty default settings here for demo purposes, just to show you the concept. So we click on sync, it will start to synchronize for the first time, and it will push those to the web server. And if now anything changes here, like I change the color of this one, you will start to see that in the log that that file will be synchronized with the web server file. So any change we make here will be detected within that 5 second time frame, and it will be pushed to the server. So that takes care of that. So we have CSV files, we have them pushing to the cloud platform. So now I'll show you my VPS, share a chart on the VPS here. That's why I like Vulture a lot. It's a very stable VPS service. Only run my trading software there. And what we're gonna do here, I have the import level study set at a 10 second interval, and I need to use the hosted CSV file option, and we're gonna point to that ES, this is the ES chart lines file. So that ES lines file, let's check it again. This is ES, the lines as a file name. That's right here, CSV lines ES. So we're gonna copy that and we paste it here. But now we need still to put a URL host name in front. So we're gonna get that from this little page right here. So this is your server information. We just use that IP number as our address to that file. So that's going to go in front of the file name with a slash there. And this will be used as the file name to point to. I'm going to show lines, and you have to refer to the other video on all the settings here. But this will show us the same lines as we have in the creation share a chart. There we go. You see we have a blue line here and a yellow line there. And if you go to that ES chart, here you see a thick blue and a thick yellow line. So let's change the line width of both of these lines, and let's see how long it takes to get that change happen. There we go, the change happened. Within 5 seconds, the file was updated, synced to the cloud platform, and this study here is checking every 10 seconds for updates. So within that window, you will have your changes. So if you start to move this around, move it there, you will see it change on the VPS one as well. There you go. You also notice that this is a 15-minute chart, and the source chart here is a two-point range chart. So they will be copied no matter what the time frame is of the chart. And the same we can do for zones. Now if you want to see zones, let's change this to the zones file. So the zones file is named like this. you need to change the zones to that, and the zone width needs to be column number 2. And with that set, you will get the zones visible as we have in this source platform. So if you're going to change the color for this to green, and we're going to add a new one, a purple one there, we just wait a couple of seconds here to get updates. That's the first update. And I'm expecting the other update as well. So see, the line labels work, the colors work fine, and the start and the start date and time work well as well. So this is the concept. We can do that for CL as well, but I think you get the point right now. That was my demo. You can create CSV files on the fly, sync them on the background, and anybody with the link can show them on their own chart. So if you run a room, if you trade with friends, or if you run share a chart on two different computers on different locations, you can use this to synchronize your lines and zones and price levels. If you have any questions, let me know, and I'll be looking to help you out. Bye-bye.